Hello everyone, I'm Shivam Pasari and welcome to ASIN Academy. So as you can see from the title of this video, in this video we'll solve another good question on the topic of factors number theory, and this question has been taken from Bstat Honours and Bmath Honours Admission Test 2015. Now the question is as follows: the number of factors of 2 raised to power 15 into 3 raised to power 10 into 5 raised to power 6, which are either perfect squares or perfect cubes or both, is. Now we are provided 4 options for this question: option A 252, option B 256, option C 260, and option D 264. So this was our question, and I would like you to try this question first by yourself and then come to this video for the solution. I hope that you have tried the question and you have got the solution, and if you didn't, then let's check the solution. So according to our given question, we are given a number that is 2 raised to power 15 into 3 raised to power 10 into 5 raised to power 6, and we have to find how many factors of this number are either perfect square or perfect cube or both of them. Now, our first step in such cases is to prime factorize the number. Now, we can see that the number is already prime factorized because all the numbers in the basis are 2, 3 and 5, which are prime numbers raised to whole numbers. Now, our second step is to follow a simple procedure, which is, if we have to find the number of factors which are perfect square, then we have to divide all the powers of the prime numbers by 2 and add 1 and then take the greatest integer of it. So let's say if we have a number a raised to power p into b raised to power q into c raised to power r, and we have to find that how many factors of these numbers are perfect square, then my answer will be greatest integer of p by 2 plus 1 into greatest integer of q by 2 plus 1 into greatest integer of r by 2 plus 1, and so on and so forth, as many prime numbers and powers are there. So in this case, 2 raised to power 15 into 3 raised to power 10 into 5 raised to power 6, my perfect square factors will be 15 by 2 plus 1 into 10 by 2 plus 1 into 6 by 2 plus 1. Now, if we take 15 by 2 plus 1 in the greatest integer function, we'll get 8, then we'll get 6, and then we'll get 4, which on multiplication gives us the result as 192. So we have 192 perfect square factors. Now, in the case of perfect cube, instead of 2, we'll just write 3. Now, in that case, we'll have 15 by 3 plus 1 in the greatest integer function, 10 by 3 plus 1 into 6 by 3 plus 1. And from that, we'll get 6 into 4 into 3, which is equal to 72. So you'll think that our final answer is 192 plus 72, that is equal to 264. But you are slightly wrong in this, because there will be some numbers that we have double counted, because we have taken once 2 and then 3, and there may be multiple of both 2 and 3. So what we have to do is, we have to subtract those numbers. So we have to subtract all the numbers which are multiple of both 2 and 3 in the powers. So we have to subtract all the perfect 6s. So for that, we'll just write 6 in this denominator. So for that, we'll have 15 by 6 plus 1, which is equal to 3, that is in the greatest integer function. Then we'll have 10 by 6 plus 1 in the greatest integer function, that will give us 2. Again, 6 by 6 plus 1 in the greatest integer function, that will again give us 2. So final answer for that will be 12, and we have to subtract 264 with 12. So our final answer for this given question is 264 minus 12, that is 252.